Hello and welcome friends. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about chapter 4 of Ashtanga Hridaya. So before starting the chapter, I request you all to please change your quality settings in video for better quality graphics. So now let's start the chapter. So the name of chapter is Roganutpadaniya, right? So the word Roganutpadaniya is made up of two words. First is roga and second is anutpadaniya. So the roga means disease and anutpadan. Here anutpadan is a opposite of utpadan word. As we know that utpadan means production. So anutpadan means prevention of production. So the overall meaning of roga anutpadaniya is prevention of onset of disease, right? So basically in this chapter we are going to we will be dealing with the preventive healthcare aspect, right? Now first we will see the natural urges or vakes, right? So these are the urges which is produced naturally in the human body. These are the natural urges or vakes, like feces, urination and farting. These all are the common example of urges, right? So basically the natural urges are of two types. First is non-suppressible urges and suppressible urges. Non-suppressible urges is also known as adharaniya vegs, and suppressible urge is also called dharaniya vegs. Okay, so in this chapter basically we will be focusing on these two vegs, adharaniya vegs and dharaniya vegs. Now we will see the adharaniya vegas or non-suppressible vegas. So the shloka for adharaniya vega is vegana na dharyet vatavina mudra chavatrat chudama nidrakas shram swas jramba ashru chardi retasam. So the adharaniya vegas, right? These are the natural urges which one should not suppress, right? So the meaning of shloka is vegana na dharyet. It means one should not suppress these natural urges. Now these are the natural urges, that is vata, vita, mutra. Here vata means flatus or farting, vit means feces, and mutra means urine, right? So farting or passing stool and passing the urine or urination, right? These are the three natural urges which one should not suppress. Now here some more natural urges are given in the shloka that should also not suppress, right? That is chava. It means sneezing, or in Hindi we will say chikna. And trat, it means thirst or pyas lagna. Next is chudam, it means hunger or bhook lagna. And then in second line, first is nidra, it means sleep. Kas, it means coughing or khasiana. And shram swas, it means breathing on exertion. If somebody does hard exercise, then after the hard exercise, here rate of breathing will get increased suddenly, because their body needs more amount of oxygen in this condition. So this condition is called hyperventilation, right? So this is the breathing on exertion. या फिर आप कुछ ज़्यादा hard exercise करते हैं तो आपकी बॉडी को ज़्यादा ऑक्सीजन की ज़रूरत होती है, तो उस कंडीशन में आप जो ब्रीदिंग रेट है आपका वो बढ़ जाता है. सो दैट कंडीश्शन इज नोन एज श्रम श्वास. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज जम्भा. जम्भा मीन्स योनिंग और उबासी आना. एंड देन नेक्स्ट इज अश्रु, इट मीन्स टीयर्स एंड वीपिंग. एंड द लास्ट इज छर्दी और वोमिटिंग, राइट? एंड रेतसाम, It means ejaculation of semen. So these all are the natural urges which one should not suppress. Otherwise, he will be having several complications in their body, which we will be seeing in the next shloka. Now first, we will see the adhovata rodha or flatus. So adhovata rodha, here adho means moving downwards, vata means air, and rodha means suppression. So the meaning is suppression of air which is moving downwards in the body. So in this shloka, we will see the adverse effect of suppressing the flatus, right? So the shloka is adhovatasya rodhena gulmo urdhvavarta ruk kalmaha vata mutra shakrat sanga drasht yagniha vadha hadgadaha, right? So adhovatasya rodhena, it means if any person is habitually suppressing the flatus, then he will be prone to following complications. So the complications are gulmo davarta, right? So here gulmo means abdominal bloating, and udvarta, here udvarta means upward movement of vata, right? Or upward movement of air. Here ruk means abdominal pain, and klama, it means tiredness, right? Ruk means abdominal pain and klama means tiredness. Now we will see the second line of shloka, that is vata mutra shakrata. It means retention of feces, urine and flatus, right? Here vata means flatus, mutra means urine, and shakrata, it means feces, right? And angadrashta, it means loss of vision. Yagni, it means decreased digestive power. And hradgadaha, it means disease of heart. So these all are the complications which will be happened or which will be occurred if person is habitually suppress the flatus. Now here the question comes that why these complications are occurring because of suppression of flatus. So the answer is actually naturally what happens in intestine and rectum region, natural movement of vata is downward, right? But because of suppression of flatus, vata moves in upward direction, right? And this cause all these problems, right? So all these problems are occurring in the body because of vata imbalance, right? So this is the reason for all these complications which is given in the shloka. Now we will see the adverse effect of suppressing feces. So first is pindiko dveshtha. It means twisting pain of calf muscles. Second is pratishaya. It means running of nose. Third is shiro rujaha. It means headache. Now in second line, fourth is urdhu vayuha. It means upward movement of vata. Then parikarto. It means itching sensation in anal region. Then radayosyo parodhanam. It means stiffening feeling in chest region, or simply we can say tightness of chest. Then in last line, mukhen vit pravattischa. It means feces coming from the mouth, or in simply we can say vomiting, right? Last is purvokatascha amayaha ismrataha. It means the symptoms which we have seen earlier in earlier shloka. So all the symptoms which is caused by suppression of flatus will also be occurred in this condition. Here please read the feces as a flatus. in last line. In the next shloka, we will see the adverse effect of suppression of urine, right? So here, first adverse effect is Anga Bhanga. It means splitting pain all over the body, right? Second is Ashmari. It means stone in bladder. And third is Basti Medra Vankshana Vedanaha. Here, Vedna means pain, Basti means bladder, Medra means penis, and Vankshana means groin. So, pain in bladder region, penis region, and groin region. Now, the second line of shloka states that Mutrasya Rodhat Purvecha Prayo Rogaha. It means diseases that are mentioned in the flatus and feces may also occur in this condition. Now we will see the treatment of suppressing of flatus, feces and urine. Okay. So as of now, we have seen that due to suppression of either flatus, feces and urine, our vata dosha in the body is getting aggravated. So accordingly, our treatment approach, the aim of our treatment will be reducing the vata dosha in body. So accordingly, these are the treatment which helps in reducing the vata dosha. So the first treatment is Varti. Varti means rectal and urethral suppositories, right? Second treatment is Abhyanga or oil massage. Third is Avagaha. It means tap bath and steam bath, right? Or it is also called steam bath. And second is Swedana. It is similar to Avagaha. It is a type of sweating therapy or sudation therapy. Fifth is Basti Karma. It means rectal enema. And last is Avapidka Sneha. It means drinking high doses of ghee before food and after digestion of food in case of disease caused by suppression of urination, right? So these all were the treatment for suppressing the flatus, feces and urine. Thank you.